Hello, boys and girls. Hello, mums and dads. Hello, grandpas and grandmas. Great to see you. Welcome to Online Circle Time. My name's Malcolm, and this is my good friend, Miss Ellen.
Hi.
And we're here to bring you all the usual things that you enjoy so much. Now, today we're thinking about rainy day. Now, I wonder if you're near a window. Maybe you could walk over to the window or even look out of it and see if it's raining where you are. Now, I love the sunshine. I've got to be honest, that's why I moved to California from England, because do you know what? I've had too many rainy days. What about you, Miss Ellen? Do you enjoy the rain?
I like the rain. I need the rain for my fruit trees and my flowers.
Oh, because rain is very important. And some people love the rain because they just like to see it and feel it. And some people like the sunshine so they can go out. Well, whatever, we're going to think about rainy day today. And I'm so glad that you're there, able to join us. Well, we're going to sing our first song today, and it's the song we always start with. It's our ABC song. So get ready, get a big breath of air in your lungs so you're ready to sing nice and loud, and here we go. Are you ready?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Good job, everyone. Now, I am going to not choose a letter today, but because we're thinking about rainy day, I'm going to either pretend to be or show you some pictures of animals that are to do with rain. Can you think of some animals that really love rain? Well, the first one is a very small animal, and it crawls along the ground and it takes its home with it wherever it goes. Any idea what animal I'm talking about? It begins with the letter S. It is a snail. A snail. There he is, looking very happy. Can you see him there? Do you notice that? When you come out of your house after there's been lots of rain, you often see snails, don't you? And you notice this. You start looking out for this, that they always come out after the rain. Okay, what's our next one? Our next one is an animal that begins with W. And this is also an animal that loves to come out after it's rained. Again, it crawls along the ground and it's very wriggly and it likes to live in the dirt. Any idea what it is? It is a wiggly worm there, beginning with W. Yeah, now the reason that the worms come out is because they love the rain and they love to be able to dig in and out of the mud. They do love that. But when it rains, there's another animal that comes out, and this animal begins with either an F or a T. It's a frog or a toad. Here's the picture of the frog or toad, and they make a noise like ribbit. Ribbit. Now, do you know why the frogs and toads come out during the rain? Well, they love the rain, but they also like to come after the worms that have just come out. So when the worms come out, they have fun, but they have to be careful not to be eaten by the frogs or the toads. And there's one more animal that loves the rain, and it's an animal that begins with the letter S, and it's an animal that goes along the ground and it kind of does this, it slithers along. It is, of course, a snake. There's our happy-looking snake. It looks a bit like Kevin the King Snake, doesn't he? Now, the reason the snakes come out when it rains is because they like to eat frogs and toads. And, of course, the frogs and toads come out because they like to eat the worms. So everyone seems to be eating each other. Yes, that's what the rain does. Well, isn't that interesting that all these animals love the rain? We're going to sing this through one more time. And as we do so, we're going to wait till we come to the letter R, because the word rain begins with R, and we're going to shout that one out louder than all the others. Are you ready? Here we go. Nice and loud, nice and fast.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Great. Great job, everybody. I'm going to give you some high fives. Here we go. Double high fives for you for that. Well done.
Okay, it's time for what's in the bag. What I've got in my bag today is black with spots all over it. Can you guess what it is? No? I'll give you three clues. It's something you use in the rain. It's something that keeps you dry. And it's something that becomes bigger. See how that works? When I stand under this, the rain can't get on my head. I hope you have one of these. Okay, we've been talking about rain. Now let's do our rainbow song. Ready?
Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. That's all the colors of the rainbow. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. That's all the colors of the rainbow.
Maybe if it rains and the sun comes out, we'll see a rainbow.
Hello, Rhonda. You look wet.
That's because I am wet.
Have you just had a shower?
No.
A bath? Maybe you're just very sweaty.
I am not sweaty.
Well, why are you so wet then?
I've been outside in the rain.
Oh, is it raining?
Well, it was raining, but I think it's stopped now.
Oh, that's a shame. I wanted to go outside.
You can still go outside, even though it's wet on the ground.
But the bottom of my feet will get wet.
Yes, but that's not as bad as all of you getting wet.
I get wet when the ground is wet.
What do you mean?
Well, my whole body is touching the ground all the time, so it doesn't matter if it's raining or not. Oh, yes. If the ground is wet, then I get wet.
Do you not like getting wet?
I don't mind it. Sometimes it's fun. I like jumping in puddles.
So do I. That's one of my favorite things.
Yeah, I'm really bad at jumping. I love hopping too.
Oh yes, hopping is great.
Yeah, I can't hop either. And bouncing. Don't forget bouncing.
Oh, bouncing is the best, especially in and out of puddles.
No, I can't bounce.
The only problem is that it takes me so long to get dry.
Oh, yes, me too. It doesn't take me long. The water rolls right off me.
Does it?
Yes, that's the good thing about having scales.
Hello and welcome again to Craft Corner, that moment of our video where we make something or we draw something, either myself or Miss Ellen, with the idea that you try it at home. Now sometimes some of what we do is quite tough, but what you can do, you can go over and watch the video over and over again and maybe try to remember some of what we've done. But try and have a go at this, and sometimes they look complicated, but when you start, you can find that you can do it too. And today we're going to draw a picture of a rainy day. Now what I've done here, I've just drawn two people in their rain boots standing in a puddle. Now a lot of people have told me they have a lot of trouble when they draw puddles. How does a puddle look like a puddle? Well, I hope in there you can see exactly what's going on. But let's draw it and then let's see if I can talk you through some of what we're going to do. So what we're going to start with, you know, the first thing I'm going to do is put my glasses on, and then I'm going to tell you what you're going to need. You're going to need a piece of white paper. You're going to need a pencil. I've got my special mechanical pencil here. You're going to need an eraser, maybe a black pen, but also different coloured pens as well. I've got a selection there of different colours. Now, you might want to use crayons, you might want to use wax pastels, anything you like, as long as there's some colour. So what I'm going to do, first of all, I'm going to draw two pairs of rain boots. I'm going to make these quite big. Okay, so I'm sure that when you go out in the rain, you like to wear your rain boots. Okay, and we're going to put those somewhere in the middle of the page. And then what we're going to do is we're going to give some legs to these. Now, I'm not going to draw the legs very complicated. I'm just going to draw two straight legs there. And then we're going to draw the puddle. Now, the puddle is going to be like a big, big oval, like a big plate. But when you look at it from this angle, it just looks like a big flat oval, okay? And now what we're going to do is we're going to put where the end of the land is, and that's called the horizon. So I'm going to put the horizon over there. Quite simple, really, if you just follow these simple guidelines. And then we're going to put some big fluffy clouds. I'm going to make these very simple, okay? Big fluffy clouds in the background. And now we're going to draw our reflections. And when we draw a puddle or when we draw water, it's the reflections that help us understand what we're looking at. Now, this is the trick. I'm going to turn it upside down like this, and then I'm going to draw the boots again, very softly like this, okay? And then very softly with this one. And we're doing all the work in pencil, first of all, because it's good to do things in pencil so that we get it right, and then we can draw it again in pen once we're sure that we've got everything in the right place. Now, you might want to take a bit longer over this than I'm going to do, and we're going to put the legs in there. And then we're also going to try and imagine that the clouds are in here as well. So that's what we've got at the moment. Now, this is before the colours come in. So watch what I do here. The first thing I'm going to draw is the sky. Now, I'm just going to do it as a series of lines like this. And I'm not going to go into the legs, I'm not going to go into the clouds. I'm just going to put some blue in the sky there. But now here's the fun part. While I've got my blue in the hand, I'm going to put the blue in the puddle as well. So watch what I do here. Now all my lines in the puddle are going to go sideways, okay? Because water ripples sideways. So the blue's in, and now what I'm going to draw is I'm going to draw the two different colour boots. So to begin with, I'm going to make this pair of boots nice and yellow, like this. Do any of you have yellow rain boots? And what I'm going to do, I'm going to do the same thing on this side, but in the reflection, all my lines again are going to go sideways. But I'm going to put the yellow boots in here, and I'm going to make them a little bit wibbly-wobbly, okay? Just because in a puddle, the water might be moving a little bit, and it might be a little bit ripply, okay? And now I'm going to do the same with the other side. This time I'm going to take my pink and I'm going to put some pink boots down here. So again, I'm going to go up and down on the colours on this one, on this side, and the same with this one. And then I'm going to do some sideways lines again on this side, some wibbly-wobbly lines to show that the reflection in the water is moving a little bit. Okay, so here we go with those lines. And there we go, we've got a reflection of the two boots. Now I'm going to make it a little bit easier to see. I'm going to put some green to show the grass in the background. So we can imagine that we're in a field, okay? Now none of that is going to be reflected. So we can have all the lines going this way, and we can do that below the puddle as well. There we go, there's all the colours done. Can you see all the colours there now? One last thing I'm going to do, I'm going to take my black pen and I'm going to go over all the big lines so that you can see how much better it looks when there's a stronger outline. And that's what a black pen does. So I'm really just going over the same areas again. So when it comes to the reflections, I'm going to draw my lines a little bit like this, okay? And that's showing the ripples in the water, okay? Now maybe mums and dads, this is something that you can practice and then you can teach your children yourself. But it's a good way to learn how to draw reflections and to show a rainy day. Put a few more there as well. This is the other side of the puddle. Okay, we're nearly there. Well done if you've done this. I tell you, this is maybe one of the harder ones you're gonna do. I'm gonna put a pair of legs there and another pair of legs there. Ooh. Here we go. And I'm going to cut a couple of little lines to show that's where the knees are, okay? And there we have our rainy day picture of two people in their rain boots standing in a puddle.
The itsy bitsy spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider climbed up the spout again. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider climbed up the spout again.
A long, long time ago, the Bible tells the story of a man who built a great big boat. The biggest boat ever at the time, because no one had ever built a boat before. Now, the man's name was Noah. Why did he build a boat? He built a boat because God told him to. Now, here's an interesting thing. He didn't build the boat near a river or near a sea. In fact, he built it in the middle of dry land. Why would he do that? More than that, it had never rained up until this time. Well, God said to him, he liked Noah and said, Noah, I am not very happy with how people are living, how they behave, how they treat each other. People are cruel and unkind to each other, and I've had enough because they're just hurting each other and killing each other. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start again. I'm going to send so much rain that the whole world is covered with water, and then we will start again after that. And so he tells him to build this big boat. And God said, I will bring the animals to you that you need to put in the boat so that you and your family and the animals that I bring, they will be safe. And Noah did exactly as God said. And with the help of his three sons, he made this enormous boat called the Ark. And we know it as Noah's Ark. And I think lots of people laughed at him. Lots of people thought, why are you building a big boat? That's a crazy thing to do. But Noah believed God. And what happened? The rains did start to come. In fact, so much rain came, just as God said, that it wasn't long before the boat started to float. And after a while, the only people still alive were Noah and his wife, their three sons and their three wives, and the animals that were safe on board the ark. In fact, if you weren't on the ark, you weren't going to be saved. And so God did this through Noah, and he did exactly as he said, and for 40 days and 40 nights, it kept on raining. Well, the rain finally stopped, but the waters covered the earth for 150 days. And after that time, the water started to go down. And when the water came down, suddenly Noah found himself on dry land. The ark stopped floating, and there it was on dry land. And God made a promise. He said, Noah, what I did was very serious because people's behavior was so bad, so terribly bad, I had to do this. But he said, I'm never going to do that again. And to show you, I'm going to make you a special promise. I'm going to put something in the sky so that every time you see it, it will be a reminder that God has promised never to flood the earth again. Do you know what that sign is? What's something that we notice after it's rained and maybe when the sun comes out? Shall I show you? It is, of course, a rainbow. When God put the rainbow in the sky, that was his promise that he would never flood the earth again. Well, we've come to our last song today. And today we've been thinking about rain and water. And of course, our last song is about a lot of water, so much water that it's made a great big ocean. And of course, we're thinking about things that live in the ocean. It's our favorite fish, it's slippery fish. So get up out of your seats and get ready to maybe do the motions as we sing this song together. Are you ready? Here we go.
Slippery fish, slippery fish, sliding through the water. Slippery fish, slippery fish. Oh, oh, oh.
Oh It's been eaten by an octopus tickling through the water. Octopus. Oh no! It's been eaten by a tuna fish flashing through the water. Tuna fish. Oh no! It's been eaten by a great white shark lurking in the water. Great white shark. Oh no! It's been eaten by a
humongous whale,
spouting in the water.
Humongous whale.
What do we say when we burp? We say, excuse me. Thank you for joining us today. We hope you've had fun. We hope you've enjoyed all those thoughts about rain and rainbows and umbrellas. And if it is raining and you go outside, be sure to splash in some of those puddles. Make sure you've got your rain boots on first and have a wonderful day. We look forward to seeing you again soon. So it's goodbye from me, Malcolm, and goodbye from my friend, Miss Ellen.
Bye.
We'll see you again soon. Bye, everybody.